Hello guys, this is Georg. I'm a postdoc at Vanderbilt, and this is an introduction into writing Rosetta protocols with Rosetta scripts. Rosetta provides different user interfaces to support different use cases and workflow styles. The command line was the first and is probably still the most often used Rosetta interface. In Rosetta's bin directory, you find a long list of applications that can be run from the command line. However, command line applications are developed for certain specific use cases. They are less flexible, and there might be more things that you want to do with Rosetta. For certain scientific tasks, you might want to modify an existing protocol, combine two or more protocols, or make an entire new protocol. How can you write new protocols with Rosetta? Rosetta provides additional user interface. You can directly modify the Rosetta source code, which is written in C++, and write new C++ programs. However, this requires knowledge in C++ coding, and you have to know the Rosetta code base. In addition, Rosetta provides two popular and more easy-to-use scripting interfaces, Rosetta Scripts and PyRosetta. PyRosetta is a collection of Python bindings to the source code and allows flexible and fast custom protocol development. However, PyRosetta also requires that you know the Rosetta code and that you can interact with Rosetta functions. Rosetta Scripts uses extensible markup language to build complex protocols using core functionality implemented in Rosetta's codebase. Rosetta Scripts has the advantage that it does not require expert knowledge of the Rosetta code. No matter what interface you use, any new protocols that you develop have to be tested carefully to make sure that they work correctly, not only technically correct, but that they also produce scientifically meaningful results. Now let's talk about how we actually use Rosetta scripts. There are essentially two components. The first component is an XML file, which defines how the computational protocol looks like and what are the operations. This file is specified on the command line with the option parser protocol. The second component is the Rosetta Scripts command line application. This will read the XML file and invoke whatever procedure is dictated in the XML file. In addition, the user has to provide other command line options, for instance, an input PDB file or a list of PDB files, and options needed to set up the computational operations defined in the XML file. Essentially, Rosetta Scripts is a collection of operations and objects. Those operations are defined in extensible markup language, XML. Here you can see a template of a Rosetta Scripts XML file. XML is a widely used language for representing hierarchical data. Elements are defined by tags, which are enclosed in brackets. Each tag can include multiple subtags. Everything that is not within brackets is interpreted as a comment. The main components of the Rosetta Scripts XML file fall into two categories: movers and filters. Movers will take a protein pose and modify its conformation. Filters will calculate a score value or some other metric for a protein model and decide whether it should go into the next stage. The order in which movers and filters are applied is specified in the protocol section of the XML file. Now let's look how we write tags in Rosetta scripts. Here is an example of a tag that defines a mover. Each mover definition will look like this. The first keyword is the name of the mover. It must be one of the predefined set of movers that Rosetta recognizes. The second keyword is a unique name for that particular instance of mover. Under this name, the mover can be referenced elsewhere in the XML file. And the third keyword is a number of settings needed to fully define the mover. For example, the score function used by the mover. Most Rosetta Scripts elements have a required list of settings and default values, which you can find in the documentation. On the next slides, we will see some of the most often used elements in Rosetta Scripts. The basic building blocks of Rosetta Scripts are movers. Movers usually modify the protein pose. They are applied in the order in which they are defined in the protocol section. Some mover also can compute a matrix. A single mover can be used more than once in the protocol, for example, to write loops or sequences of movers. Another essential element in the Rosetta Scripts protocol are filters. Filters will calculate a score value or some other metric for a protein model and decide whether the model should go into the next stage or not. If a filter is not satisfied, the trajectory will be killed and Rosetta will carry on with the next trial. This is meant to reduce the amount of computation that is conducted on conformations that show no promise of success. Filters can also be used to compute data for a protein model. However, this is not the preferred way of doing it. A better way of doing it is to use simple metrics. An essential section in the Rosetta Scripts XML file is the score function section. Here the score functions that will be used in filters and movers are defined. The name provided under the name attribute is the name that will be used for that score function in movers and filters. Therefore, the name should be unique so that different score function definitions are not overwritten. Different parts of a protocol can use the same or different score functions. Users can also customize default score functions by using the reweight and set tags. With the reweight tag, it is possible to change or add the weight for a given score type. And with the set tag, the user can change the way how a score term is calculated. The recent Rosetta version also allows it to use the same score function to score symmetric and non-symmetric poses. A very helpful element in Rosetta Scripts are residue selectors. Residue selectors are used by movers, filters, or task operations to dynamically select residues at runtime. That's why residue selectors are very helpful. Residues can be specified based on different properties, for example, their position in the amino acid sequence, their location at a protein interface, or the spatial distance between residues. However, not all movers need residue selectors to define a set of residues. There are also movers, for example, the setup metals mover, that can define the set of residues on which they operate by a simple list or range of residue numbers. Another essential element in Rosetta Scripts are task operations. Task operations control the behavior of the packer. In Rosetta, the so-called packer is used to sample sidechain conformations and mutate residues. By default, the packer changes every possible protein residue to every other amino acid or sidechain rotamer. This behavior can be changed by packer tasks, which are used by movers such as the pack rotamers mover. Now, task operations are used to configure a so-called task factory and generate specific packer tasks. And in this way, the behavior of the packer can be changed. The packer tasks control which residues are packable, designable, or held fixed. In other words, when used by certain movers, the set of task operations control what happens during packing. In Rosetta, there are several different task operations available. For example, the read-res file task operation will read a list of packable or designable residues from a text file. The restrict to repacking task operation will restrict all residues to repacking and turn off design. And the restrict residue to repacking task operation will restrict a single residue to repacking and turn off design. Another very helpful feature in Rosetta scripts are simple metrics. Simple metrics can be used to run analysis on a protein model. For example, calculation of RMSD, scores, distances, angles, torsions, or secondary structure. This data then can be written out to a score file using the run simple metrics mover or can be dumped into some database using the simple metrics features reporter. I already mentioned the protocol section at the beginning of my talk. In this section, the order in which movers and filters are executed is specified. Movers and filters can be mixed and matched, and they can be executed more than once in the protocol. And in this way, very complex protocols can be built. The last section in the Rosetta XML file is the output tag. The output tag allows setting certain output options, for example, the score function used to score the pose before it is written out. The output tag must be the very last tag before the closing Rosetta Scripts tag. Oftentimes it is desirable to run a series of different Rosetta Scripts jobs with slightly different parameters. Instead of creating a number of different XML files, one can use script variables and variable substitution to do the job. In this example XML file, there is a variable called resfile, which is enclosed by percentage signs. And when we use the option parser script vars, the value of that option will be used to replace the variable. In this case, the variable resfile will be replaced by the actual name of the resfile, a105t.resfile. Now we bring all the things together. Here is shown a simple Rosetta Scripts XML file for calculating the RMSD between a Rosetta model and a reference PDB structure. We can execute this Rosetta Scripts XML file with the command shown in red, which we run from the terminal. In the XML file, there are two residue selectors defined. The first residue selector defines the region of the Rosetta model that should be used for the RMSD calculation. And the second residue selector defines the region for RMSD calculation in the reference structure. The two residue selectors are used in the definition of the RMSD metric. And the RMSD metric is finally used by the run simple metrics mover, which gets executed by adding its name to the protocol section. There are two little resources that might be helpful for you when you work with Rosetta Scripts. One is this application, Validate Rosetta Scripts, which can be used to check the format of your Rosetta Scripts XML file to make sure that they follow the XML schema of Rosetta. And for your convenience, this little short test is executed every time you start the Rosetta Scripts application. Another helpful script is rewrite rosettascripts.py, which can be used to convert old Rosetta XML scripts, which were written before 2017, to the currently used XML format in Rosetta. We are now getting to the end of this short presentation about Rosetta scripts. If you want to read more about it, here are some useful links. On the Rosetta Commons website, you can find a list of available movers, filters, residue selectors, task operations, etc., and information on how they are defined. In addition, several papers about Rosetta scripts have been published and their application to different use cases such as protein ligand docking. I hope you find this presentation helpful. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.